Dear learners, in today's video tutorial, we'll show how to conduct panel data regression. Particularly, we'll discuss how to perform fixed effect and random effect model regression using panel data. So, this is the Stata software, and let's go to the data file. So, here are our variables. What we are trying to do here, our dependent variable is greenhouse gas emission, which we believe that this is a function of two explanatory variables. So our greenhouse gas emissions is actually affects by, it is the beta coefficient. The first one is the assets of an organization. It could be any fixed asset like machineries, furnitures, or transports. And our another explanatory variable is the profitability. So we have two explanatory variables, assets and profitability, and our dependent variable is greenhouse gas emission. Now let's go to the data file. These are different firm, so these are the different firm name, and we have to assign a code, ID code for each of this firm. So like for AAL, I have assigned 1, and for the second firm I have assigned the code 2, for the third I have assigned the 3. So we need to assign our firm ID against the full name of each firm. And you see the year, so we have taken the sample period from 2013 to 2019. So first firm, and it has an observation from 2013 to 2019. And these are the greenhouse gas emission data. So this is the metric term, and this is the asset size. So it is the measured in the million pounds, and this is the profitability measured in terms of return on assets. And similarly, we have then used the second firm, and this is the year 2013 to 2019. So this is the exactly the same format that we have discussed previously. Now, to use the panel data in the Stata, first you need to declare your data set to be panel. So, to declare your data set to be panel, you need to type XD set, and you have a firm ID, so you need to put that one firm ID, and then you need to put your time, that is here year, and since our data is yearly, so I can type yearly, and if you press enter, it will give you this result. Another way of doing this using this menu option, so you need to go to the statistics. You can see here, here is the longitudinal or panel data option, and under this setup and utilities, and there's option declare data set to be panel data. You click here, and you need to select your panel ID variable, that is firm ID, and you need to select time variable, that is year. So panel ID variable, so that is actually our sample unit, that is firm ID, and time variable is year. And since this is the yearly data, so if you had monthly data, I need to click monthly, but this is the yearly, so I'm clicking yearly, and okay. So it says that this is panel data, but this is unbalanced because there is some missing observation here. Now this is the first step. Now we'll perform fixed effect model and random effect model. So we'll perform both type of regression first, and then we'll later discuss which one is more appropriate for our data set. So to perform fixed effect model, okay, how can we do this? This is a very simple formula or simple command that we need to use. So remember, first we need to declare our data set to be panel. Next, xtreg, and then you need to put your first you need to put your dependent variable at first, so greenhouse gas emission, and then you need to put your independent variable, that is assets and profitability. You press comma, and this is the fixed effect model. So you write FE, so FE means fixed effect. So if you press the enter, so you get the result. So this is the fixed effect model result. So you can see here, assets, this is positively affects the greenhouse gas emission. That means the more you have your fixed asset, the higher will be the greenhouse gas emissions. And this is statistically significant because it is less than 1% or even less than 0.001. Although profitability, this positively affects, but this is not statistically significant because it is greater than 5% or even 10%. However, the model is statistically significant. So you can see here it is less than 0.001 or even less than 1%, whatever you say. And this is the R-square value. Now, we'll perform random effect model. So first we show you how to do fixed effect, now random effect. So this is the random effect model. So to perform this random effect model, similarly you need to write first xtres, and xtres, after this you need to put your dependent variable and then two independent variable. Now for the random effect model, we use re, so re means random effect. So you press enter. This is the output of your random effect model, and this asset, so this shows the similarly previously one, that is positively affects and it is statistically significant. However, profitability is positively affect, but it is not statistically significant, and your overall model is also statistically significant. So in this way we can perform fixed effect model and random effect model. Now the question is whether you should use fixed effect or random effect. So to decide that, you need to use Hausmann test. There is a called Hausmann test. So how can you use this Hausmann test? I'm writing the command. First, xtres, y, it is greenhouse gas emission, and your two independent variable, and fixed effect. So use this formula, press enter. This is the result of fixed effect model. And then you need to store this estimate. So you need to write estimates store, and the name you like to store is as fixed. So this is the fixed. By this name we like to store the estimates. So it is, this estimation has already stored in the memory. Now you need to perform random effect model. So you know, so xtres, our dependent and two independent, and random effect. This is done here. And then similarly, we need to estimates. We need to store these estimates. So estimates store. Now we can store it as a name of random, right? So both this estimation has been stored in the memory. Now you need to perform Hausmann test. So you need to write HAUSMAN, that is Hausman, and then first you need to write fixed, and then you need to write random, and you press enter. Now this is the result of Hausman test, and you get the chi-square test value and the significance value of the chi-square test. Now how can you decide which one is appropriate? You need to see this significance, the p-value, and if your p-value, its probability p-value, is less than significance level, so less than 5%, you need to use fixed effect model. And if your probability value is better than 5%, that is not significant, in that case you need to use random effect model. So here I can see our probability p value is less than 5%, so we need to use fixed effect model. So again, we can run this fixed effect model, x-race, greenhouse emission asset probability fixed effect, this one. And another variation of this equation is that if you want to use the robust standard error, so after the fixed effect or random effect, which model you need to use, just write robust after the option of F or RE. So this will give you the robust standard error. So in this way, we can perform fixed effect and random effect model regression in the Stata. Thank you.